President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. vows to accelerate government's dam and flood control projects as the Philippines braces for a severe El Nino phenomenon. Our very own Pia Gutierrez now joins us with an update. Pia, over to you. What more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has ordered government agencies to fast-track the completion of irrigation and other structures to ensure that the country has sufficient water supply by the second quarter of the year to help cushion the impact of El Nino. Marcos Jr. says he has given government agencies 4 months to complete the projects, which will include dams and flood control projects that will also be used for irrigation, making sure to prioritize that farmers still have access to irrigation by May 2024, when at least 77% of the country or 65 provinces are forecasted to be affected by drought due to the El Nino phenomenon. The Philippine leader made a statement Wednesday as he led the inauguration of the Balbalungaw Small Reservoir Irrigation Project in Lupao, Nueva Ecija. Once fully operational, this multi-purpose dam will provide irrigation for close to 1,000 hectares of agricultural land, benefiting about 560 farmers and their families. It is also expected to facilitate hydroelectric power generation and serve as a flood control mitigation infrastructure for communities along the river in the future.
Medyo komplikado, marami tayong gagawin. We have to, kagaya nito, kailangan matiyak natin na meron tayong patubig para sa mga magsasaka, number one. So we will accelerate the building of this this type of dams and flood control projects that we will also use as irrigation projects. So these are on the side of the irrigation, number one, because it's all about water. Tubig ang pinag-uusapan dito. Kaya tinitiyak natin na yung mga magsasaka unang-una para meron tayong food supply na maganda.
The president in an interview noted the need for government to be rational in the distribution of water to make sure that sectors that need it the most, such as healthcare and energy, will be prioritized. The government will also embark, according to Marcos Jr., on a new informational campaign to encourage the public to save on water and help in government efforts to mitigate the effects of El Nino. The president also assured that farmers and other individuals who will be affected by El Nino will receive government assistance. The president then proceeded to Zambales to lead the turnover of NIA-procured excavators in a ceremony also held this morning. 141 excavators were procured and will be distributed by the National Irrigation Administration for the maintenance and restoration of irrigation systems nationwide. The president says that to ensure the effective use of and effective and efficient use of agricultural land, it is also necessary to ensure that irrigation systems remain functioning properly. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Pia Gutierrez there joining us on the line. 153 members of the United Nations General Assembly, including the Philippines, voted in favor of a humanitarian ceasefire in Gaza. In a statement to the General Assembly, Philippine Permanent Representative to the UN, Antonio Lagdameo, said, while Manila condemns the October 7 attack by Hamas on Israel, Israel must consider the impact of its military action on civilians in Gaza. Lagdameo adds, the Philippines is deeply concerned with the humanitarian situation in Gaza and that a ceasefire is necessary to allow the entry of much-needed aid to the enclave. The United Nations General Assembly votes overwhelmingly to demand an immediate humanitarian ceasefire in Gaza. 153 members, including the Philippines, voted in favor of the troops. 10 were against it, including the U.S. and Israel, while 23 abstained. Unlike in the U.N. Security Council, the U.S. does not have a veto power in the General Assembly. Aside from the ceasefire, the resolution also demands the unconditional release of all hostages.
There are aspects of this resolution that we do support. We agree that the humanitarian situation in Gaza is dire and requires urgent and sustained attention, that civilians desperately need food and water and shelter and medical care. Any ceasefire right now would be temporary at the best and dangerous at worst.
This entire membership will not agree to place the blame only on Hamas, but not on Israel. That would be unjust, unfair, and inequitable. Mr. President, when you deny people freedom and dignity, when you humiliate and trap them in an open-air prison where you kill them as if they were beasts, they become very angry, and they do to others what was done to them.
UN General Assembly resolutions are not legally binding, but it carries political weight as it reflects a global view on the war. The UN's demand comes as humanitarian organizations warn of a growing crisis in Gaza with the onset of winter. More in this report.
The humanitarian situation in the Gaza Strip is growing increasingly dire, according to aid organizations working there. They say they have stopped much of their aid distribution efforts in southern Gaza because Israeli airstrikes and ground operations aimed at Hamas make it too dangerous.
The severe restrictions on aid access and delivery have only aggravated the situation, leading to starvation among Gaza's population and intensifying an already dire humanitarian crisis. Critical shortages of food, water, electricity, and fuel persist. In overcrowded shelters, scarcity of these items heightens health risks.
Medical professionals say the healthcare system is collapsing, and there are concerns about disease spreading, especially among an estimated 1 million children.
Hundreds of children lining up for a single toilet in the south. Our teams are telling us of maggots being picked from wounds and children undergoing amputations without anesthetic. More than a million children, practically all of the child population of Gaza, is left with nowhere to go as ground operations continue to expand in the south.
Israeli officials say they are doing whatever they can to allow humanitarian aid to reach those who need it. They are opening another terminal at the Kerem Shalom border crossing to speed up the Israeli inspections of the aid, which is done to prevent weapons smuggling.
In Itzana, we expanded the capabilities, the inspections, and we accelerated the process. Today, we can inspect up to 250 trucks every day in Itzana. And as I said, the problem is not Itzana. The problem is the capability of the UN agencies to collect all the international assistance that, after we are checking it, goes to Rafah.
More than 18,000 Palestinians have been killed in the fighting and almost 50,000 wounded, according to the Hamas-controlled Palestinian Health Authority in Gaza. Linda Gradstein, VOA News, Jerusalem.
Rifts between the U.S. and Israel spilling into public view. Speaking at a campaign fundraising event in Washington, U.S. President Joe Biden says Israel is losing international support in its war against Hamas due to its indiscriminate bombing of Gaza. He also called Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu's leadership the most conservative government in Israel's history. Biden's remarks were his most critical to date of Netanyahu's handling of the conflict. As for Netanyahu, he acknowledges the U.S. and Israel differ about what might follow after the war. He also vowed to defy Washington's pressure to put the Palestinian Authority in charge of Gaza once the fighting ends. Despite international pressure, Israel continues its offensive. Several casualties were reported following an Israeli airstrike in Rafah. Residents say both Rafah and Khan Yunis have been under intense Israeli bombardment and shelling in recent days. Civilians trying to flee the war were earlier told to go to those areas for their safety. Meanwhile, six Palestinians were killed in the West Bank city of Jenin following an Israeli raid. A 13-year-old was among the casualties after Israeli forces prevented an ambulance from bringing him to the hospital. Israel has confirmed the attack, claiming the Palestinians killed were hurling explosive devices and firing at its forces.